talking about my channel. Still rocking the glasses. I'm actually just on my way to pick up my contacts. Have my little pigtail cuteness with me. So today is going to be the second installment of my makeup clean out for 2014. And today I'm going to be tackling blushes. I have an entire drawer of blushes, so I figured... I figured this clean out deserved its own video. Just to reiterate, nothing that I'm getting rid of, I'm actually throwing out. The only thing that I threw out from the last video was that brow kit. That was just disgusting. I wasn't going to pass that on to anyone else. I've had that for a long time. I wasn't going to pass that on. But anything else, my mom, my sister, my brother's girlfriend, or my close friends will gladly take from me. So, yeah, it's all. Yeah, it is being passed on to someone. Don't worry about that. So anyway, let's get into it. Okay, so this is my blush collection. I just dumped everything out. I've got singles, high-end, and drugstore right here. And then I've got some palettes over there. So I'm going to start with the singles. And I think I'm just going to start pulling things that I definitely know I want to keep. Okay, so this is a blush from Clinique that I showed in a recent haul. It's called Totally Tawny, and it's just the perfect kind of brownie tone pink for fall and winter. I've used it a couple times so far, and I love it. So definitely going to hang on to this. This is a Kors blush in the color Pink Rose, I think. Yeah, Pink Rose. This was a gift from my friend Kristen when we did our swap. It is just the most beautiful kind of like nudie pink. I love it, and I love the texture of it. So definitely hanging on to this. This is another one of my favorites. It's from Illamasqua. It's called Beg, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful kind of ready tone pink that I love to wear in fall and winter. Got this last year, and the formula is so beautiful. I ordered it from Sephora. I don't think they carry Illamasqua anymore, but if you can get your hands on one of these, this color is so beautiful for fall. Another one I love is the Bronze Goddess by Estee Lauder in, oh, I guess it's just called Bronze Goddess. It's this year's Bronze Goddess Cheek Glow, and it's got this beautiful tortoise packaging. It's so pretty. It's a cream blush, but again, it's got that kind of reddy undertone. Definitely gonna keep that. Okay, and then this is one of the Clinique, what are these called again? Cheek Pops in the color Ginger Pop, which is so beautiful. Oh, so pretty. I don't know why I'm covering that up. It doesn't have a mirror. So pretty, and I have used this quite a bit, but I still really haven't even made a dent in like the flower print on it, but these are gorgeous, so I'm gonna actually just try to remember to use that more because I think it would be a pretty fall color. All right, Sigma, this is their Serene Powder Blush. I love this color, just a very beautiful neutral color, so love that. This is a MAC blush. It was limited edition from their Alluring Aquatics collection, Seduced at Sea. I really like this. I obviously need to wear it more. I have worn it a couple times. Can't even really tell, but it's just a beautiful kind of deeper nude, I guess you would say. But I kind of like a terracotta nude. Does that make sense? Anyway, definitely keeping that. Okay, another one for sure that I want to keep is the Hourglass Ethereal Lighting Blush. This is in the color, what is this one? Dim Infusion. It's the corally toned one. I wore this a lot in the summer. Love it. This was a splurge, but I really do like it. It's the Dior blush in My Rose, and it's so pretty. It's just, it's stunning. I wore this a lot, you can probably tell. It's well loved. Haven't hit pan, but I did wear it quite a bit. And again, it's just kind of that like nudie rose pink color. I love those kind of colors, if you can't tell. Benetint, which I actually wore quite a bit in the summer. I liked using it as a lip tint, actually, so I'm going to hang on to that. I wouldn't give it to anyone anyway because I applied it straight to my lips with this little thing, so yeah, I'm going to hang on to that. And then the same with the Posy Tint, Lolly Tint. I really love this. It's more of a spring, summer color for me, but when spring is here again, I know I'm gonna bust this out, so I really do like that. We've got the Essence Floral Grunge Blush, which is just this beautiful kind of like corally pink. My friend Melanie from Mr. Kong's Mom sent this to me in a swap we did last year, so I will link her below if you guys don't know who she is. She's like a really good friend of mine. You probably heard me talk about her lots. Essence Cookies and Cream, if you guys have been with me, you know I am obsessed with this. It's my favorite Essence collection to date, the Cookies and Cream collection, and this blush is so, so very pretty and pigmented. Hanging on to that. This I'm not so sure about. Down Boy by The Bomb. I went through a period of time where I did reach for it a lot, but since then I just don't. I mean, I haven't worn this in probably a year, to be honest with you. I just don't reach for it. I don't know. It's just not one that I wear, so I may pass this one along. Where to go? This is the e.l.f. HD Blush in Superstar, I think it's called. Superstar, yeah. This was a recommendation by Jen G here on YouTube. I'll link her below too. I really like it. A little goes a long way. It almost takes like a little bit of practice to get used to applying it because it is super pigmented, but it's like $3 and it's really pretty and long wearing. So, okay. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow. I guess it's an illuminating powder. I guess I probably shouldn't even have it in with my blushes. I really don't like this. And I am such a fan of Wet n Wild products because they're so affordable and usually they're really nice. This to me, every time, and I tried to wear it quite a few times, I really wanted to make it work, but it just ends up like a glitter bomb on my cheeks. Like everything, the pigmentation of the blushes or powders, I guess, kind of fades away, and I'm just left with glitter. So I am going to pass this along. I'm not sure yet to who, but yeah, I'm gonna pass this along. Okay, Becca Wild Honey, you guys may know this is my current favorite blush to date ever of life. Definitely keeping this. I think like this is one that I think I will just always repurchase. It's so beautiful. This is a Lancôme blush that was limited edition, and I honestly have not used it much at all. I got kind of sucked in by the packaging. Look how beautiful that is. Kind of don't even want to dip my brush into it, but that would be ridiculous. So I'm going to put that on my vanity and use it. Three of the Becca Beach Tint Shimmer Soufflés. I love these. These are well loved. I reach for them a lot. I've got like pretty good dips going on in all of them. Definitely going to keep them, and I would highly recommend checking them out. I do have a review, so I'll link that below. I have two of the Stila Convertible Cream Blushes, one in Lilium and one in Peony. These are gorgeous, you guys. I love them. I've mentioned them in favorites videos a few times. I'm going to hang on to them. But I am going to make a point to use them more. Oh, these are so pretty. Because I feel like cream products do go, like they expire quicker in my opinion. So I'm going to try and use those more. Okay, this is a newer blush to me from Physicians Formula. I know these have been out for a while, but I was just drawn to that kind of reddish colored heart. I thought it would be pretty. So I'm going to keep this, but again, make a point to use it more. Okay, let's talk about these. So, if you've been with me for a while, the Maybelline Master Highlight by Face Studio highlighting blushes are some of my favorite drugstore blushes. They are gorgeous. This is the color Nude, which makes just a nice kind of cheekbone highlight. If you have dark skin, ooh, this would be beautiful. Again, this one is pretty much the same. It's called Natural. It's so pretty. I mean, I can wear it and I'm quite light, but if you have a darker skin tone, you could definitely wear it as well. So versatile. Keeping those. This Coral one is my favorite of the bunch. It's so beautiful, you guys, and I wore it a ton this summer, so I'm gonna keep that. I also have this one in Mauve, which is just, oh, you guys, this is so pretty. I wasn't sure, like, I saw it so many times, but it was Christian Game that kept talking about it in her videos, and it looks so pretty on her cheeks, and I was like, okay, I will try it, and it's really pretty. Okay, I have one. No, I have two NARS blushes. This is Orgasm. I used to wear this one all the time. I have a hit pan on it. I am going to keep it. This is probably one of, I don't know, I've had this blush for a really long time, but I am going to keep it. I'm going to keep it. And then this is one of my all-time favorite blushes, period. It's called Madly, and it's just that beautiful kind of nudie-toned pink that I love. So definitely keeping that. Tarte. Dollface, again, one of my favorite blushes from Tarte. I've hit pan on that. I'm going to keep it, even though I do have a backup in a palette. I'm going to keep this. And then this is Exposed, which is another one of my favorites. Oh, so pretty. Gonna keep that. And then this is a little one called Memorable that came in a kit from last year. This is pretty, but it's a little bit too glittery for me. So I think I may pass this one on to a friend, maybe my brother's girlfriend. She might like it. I actually think I've only swatched it. Like you can still see everything's pretty intact. So I think I'm gonna pass this one on. Although I did melt it with my hair straightener. Whoops. All right, Milani blushes are some of my absolute favorite from the drugstore. I think I'm going to keep all these. Luminoso is gorgeous. I think I mentioned this in a recent favorite. It, oh, so pretty. When I start wearing this, I have a hard time using any other blush. So Luminoso, Bellissimo Bronze, which is actually really nice for the fall because it's, what are you doing, Jake? He's playing with an egg, a toy egg. Okay, going to keep that one. And then I'm going to keep both of these. What am I saying? Barry Amore. And this is the newer one, Delizioso Pink, I believe, which is a beautiful, bright, matte pink. So yeah, I'm going to keep all the Milani blushes. I love them. All right, let's talk about MAC. This is one of my favorites. It's a cult favorite. It's called Stereo Rose. It's a mineralized skin finish. It's huge, but it is so beautiful. They release this often, and I would totally recommend, you know, if it comes out in a newer collection, picking it up. We've got Warm Soul, which is another one of my favorites. It's just so pretty. Okay, so this is Dame. This is a really nice kind of pinky matte color in the springtime. I am gonna hang on to that. Okay, this is called Pink Tea. This was limited edition, and for a while I wore it and I wore it and I wore it. And I'm confused because I tried to wear it the other day and I felt like I couldn't get any pigmentation on my cheeks. It's very, very light. So I'm going to put this in the pass on pile and think about it. We've got Gingerly, cult favorite, one of my absolute favorite blushes. So, so very beautiful. Just that kind of like terracotta nude. Gorgeous. Spring Sheen, another one of my favorites. This is one that I would definitely recommend you get if you're, you know, just looking for a really beautiful universal blush. And then these two were limited edition from, I don't even know, just like some MAC collection. So this one's called Pleasure Model and it's pretty. This one is Auto Erotique. I don't know. Yeah, I need to use these. This is my problem. I have not used these two blushes very much at all. Like I think I did a blog post on them or something. I'm going to put these on my desk so that I wear them more. So onto the blush palettes that I have. These are my Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I love them. I have a review. I'll link it below. I love them so much. Gemma got a hold of this though and cracked the Z palette, but oh, I may have to order another one. These are definitely staying. Love them. This Tarte palette was, this is the Off the Cuff palette from last year. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. So very pretty. I'm definitely going to keep that. I do have the one from this year. Actually, it's just over here, right here. I'm going to be doing a review on this. Actually, this review may already be up. Okay, I have this guy from Pixie, which is like a trio. Hold on here. Okay, so it's got the bronzer and then the two blushes. This peachy colored blush is beautiful in the summer and it's got a beautiful sheen. The pink one is too. I'm not a huge fan of the bronzer, but I love both the blushes, so I'm going to keep that. Naked Flushed in Native. Again, if you've been with me for a while, I went through a period of time where I was obsessed with this. I do have a whole video on it. It's beautiful. My only complaint is that this is kind of powdery and it has spread a little to the highlighter, so I just have to be careful. But I do love this, and the three of them together are gorgeous, so I'm gonna keep this. Hey, this guy. This is the Sleek Face Form Contouring and Blush Palette in Light. Okay, even though it's in light, this bronzer is just way too dark for me. It just looks muddy on my skin. I love the highlighter. The highlighter is beautiful. And then this blush reminds me a bit of Orgasm. Yeah, let me swatch them. Okay, this is Orgasm and this is the one from the Sleek palette. They are very, very similar. Kind of the reason I was hanging on to this was because I really do like that blush. And I do like the highlighter, but I just don't reach for it because the bronzer is too dark. So because this is like pretty new, let me just do this. So, I mean, I do have a blush that's very similar and the highlighter is nice, but I have other ones that I reach for more. I think because this is pretty new and I just don't reach for it, I'm going to pass it on to my sister. She's darker than me, so I know that this bronzer would work for her. And I think, I mean, it's just like a nice newer trio that I've had this for like a year and I really don't reach for it. So she's going to get more use out of it than me, so I'm going to pass it on to her. Okay, the last thing I have here is the Laura Geller Glow Box. And this is really cute. I got it from Houtlook. It's got a little drawer. And this brush is actually kind of cute. So there's that, and then you open it up and you get the baked blush and highlighter. The blush, hopefully you can see, it's quite sparkly, but I really do like this kind of highlighter. I'm gonna hang on to this. Even just the packaging, it's different. I don't see this a lot. It needs to be wiped off. But yeah, I'm gonna hang on to that. All right, I just forgot to talk about this guy. This is the Benefit Boxed Blush in Hervana. This is so pretty in the spring and summer months. I really do love it. If you can tell, but I do have a bit of a dip in it. It's gorgeous. I'm going to keep it. I love the smell of these too. Love it. So this is definitely staying. Something I bust out more in the spring and summer, but, and the box, like how beautiful is the box? So this is definitely staying. Okay, so this is my revised blush collection. Sorry, Jake's chewing on a toy if you can hear that. These little containers I just got at the dollar store like a long time ago. I am kind of looking for something different. I don't know, I know By Allegory has some cool ones. I don't know if you guys have suggestions on better storage solutions, because like I just like how everything lines up here. It's just better. But yeah, I guess I could get more of these. Anyway, if you guys have a better storage solution, let me know. These also don't fit that well in my Alex 9 drawer. Like there's a lot of space when I put them in there. You know what I mean? Anyway, so these are all the blushes that I'm keeping, and these are the palettes. I just kept that out of there too. So I think that looks good. I still have way too much blush, but you know, I tried. Okay, and then these are the ones that I'm passing along. I think my mom will wear this. It's just like a nice kind of neutrally pink color, but I haven't used it for like a year, and I just think someone else would use it. This one I haven't touched. I have melted with a hair straightener, curling iron, I don't even know. It's just a little too glittery, so I am going to pass that on. This was just, it didn't work for me. Like I said, the powder just kind of faded. And I was just left with glitter, so not going to use that one. Pink tea, I'm so confused about this because I used to love it. But then, like I said, when I reached for it recently, it's just, maybe it's faded. Is that possible? Like, I mean, you can see I'm quite light, but this just does not show up on my cheeks anymore. So I'm going to pass this on. My mom may use this because she's quite fair and she likes to just play with makeup that I give her. She doesn't really buy her own, so she'll probably use that. And then this I'm going to send to my sister because I know this bronze shade will look beautiful on her, and I already have a blush very similar, a couple of them actually. So I'm going to send that to her. All right, so that is it for blushes. So thank you so much guys for taking the time to watch. I really hope you are enjoying this series. If you haven't subscribed, we would totally appreciate it if you did. Take care of each other and we'll see you soon. Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Say bye.
Bye.